Hi guys, this is Fearless. So welcome back to my channel. So in Season 3 of Epic War Throne, there will be 6 new tome skills that will be ready to be redeemed. So let's get right down to understanding them. So first up will be Annihilate. It will be a grade A combo skills. So the heroes you require to be redeemed are Zhang Ba, Xiahou Shuang, and Cao Hong. So the effects of the skills will be almost the same as Undaunted skills, just that it will be the intelligence version. So the whole explanation of skills will be dealing basic damage, increase the intelligence damage the target receives by 30 seconds, 10 seconds, and inflicts 165% intel damage. It will be suitable to be used by intel combo heroes like Jiang Wei, Liu Kang, or even Deng Ai itself. So next will be Firm Defense. It's a S-grade formation skills. Heroes required to be to redeem it will be Yan Yan and Xun Yu. So the effects of the skills will be in the first 60 seconds, decrease all enemies 100% foresight. And when our general receives damage from foresight, give 2 random allied general 10% critical rate, stackable to 3 times. So this is a very good skill to counter teams that have foresight buff like Shu Mastermind, and at the same time increasing the chances of our own general dealing critical hit. But if faced with a team that does not use the foresight buff, you will lose the advantage of countering and also making the disadvantage of wasting a skill slot on the skill that will not be triggered. So third will be Huang Tian Grasping Taoism. It's a grade S active skill. So the heroes required to redeem are Zhang Jue, Zhang Bao, and Zhang Liang. So effects of the skills are randomly causing 2 enemy generals 140% intel lightning damage and 240% lightning intel damage to enemy generals that are electrified. If there is no such generals, randomly choose 1 enemy generals and cause the same lightning intel damage. So these skills can be paired with Zhang Jue himself to complement his own skills elemental debuff. It can also be used with Sima Yi to create a Sima Yi lightning shield with Chao Ren, or it will also be a great additional elemental damage for both Fa Zhen and Zhuge Liang. So next will be the Burning of Xing Ye. It is a great S command skills. So heroes to require to redeem are Zhuge Liang and Chao Ren. Effects of the skills are to grant own self and one ally the highest intel. For every active or commander skills used, increase self foresight by 10% for 20 seconds, and also 50% to deal 100% fire intel damage to one random enemy. But these skills will be most useful when paired with Sima Yi's shield or Shu Mastermind, as these skills will trigger high damage by the generals with the highest intelligence. So next up, Destructive Arrows. It is a crit S passive skills. Heroes required to redeem are Han Dang, Ding Feng, and Jiang Qing. The effects of the skills will be increase archer own skills strength damage by 80%, and for every damage caused by own archer skills, increase self-critical rate for 10% for 20 seconds, stackable up to 2 times. This skill is best paired with Han Dang or Xiahou Yuan or heroes who own archer skills, allow hitting of multiple heroes with one cast. So the last skills will be to avoid the solid and strike the weak. It is a great S passive skills. And heroes required to redeem it with Zhang Liao and Ri Meng. So the effect of the skills will be randomly choose 1 back row enemy and trigger ambush, and increasing combo critical rate by 20% and also increase evasion by 20% for 20 seconds. So ambush, meaning these skills allows will not be restricted to formation and allows this skill to directly hit the back row generals. So actually these skills serve as a very good counter for single attacking nuke teams like Sun Sanxiang and Zhu Rong, thus increasing the chance of you one-shot killing the back row nuke hero or the nuke commander. But these skills can also be very easily countered by Taunt, which cancels the targeting of the back row generals. Okay, so for Season 3, there's also one new strategy that can be redeemed by using 10 4-star Archer Generals, and it is called Caltrops Trap. It can be used on any grids, and it causes damage once to any non-friendly legion, and it will cause a certain amount of injured troops. The actual effect will be tested out, and then we'll do a review on how this strategy works out, or how this strategy should be used. So with that, that's the end of my video. Thanks for watching my video once again. If you wish to see more content, please help me like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.